Hi, I'm Bob Stern. I'm a senior metrologist at Agilent Technologies. We're going to cover all of the kinds of questions that I hear most often from colleagues, from customers, and folks that are on the standards committees. So here's the list of topics that we'll be covering in this series. Right now, we're going to go into why calibrate. Before we begin, I want to talk just a little bit about philosophy. For 60 years, the philosophy at Hewlett-Packard Test and Measurement was all about accurate measurements. That's what we did. And since the year 2000, you know us as Agilent Technologies. We are the premier measurement company, and we strive, just as HP did, to always make as accurate a measurement as absolutely possible at every step in the product life cycle, when we're designing instruments, when we build them, and when we calibrate them. So perhaps it's no surprise that in the Agilent Service Support Organization, our passion, and you may detect this as you listen to me in this series, is all about accurate measurements. The only unique thing about what we do in accurate measurements in the service sector is that the device under test is your instrument. I like to start out any discussion about calibration with an open question. Why calibrate? What I hear most often is some people will say, well, we need to meet ISO 9001 for quality audit requirements. Okay. Sometimes I hear, well, we need to validate the design or manufacturing processes to make sure they're under statistical control, or often to make sure that they're within an established system error budget. And finally, most often in the aerospace defense area, I will hear people saying, hey, we need to make sure that our armed forces never have a bad day. Each of these is a different use case for instruments, and what you'll see reflects different deliverables and requirements for calibration. So throughout the series, hopefully we will address all three of these use cases so that you can see, depending on where you fit, which calibration service and which deliverables are most important to your company. Now, before we jump into calibration, I want to cover, why do you buy Agilent instruments? When you select a particular product, you may very well know from our website, many of our product lines have lots of instruments. This one happens to be spectrum analyzers, and notice that there's 30 different model numbers. So how do you select which model number you want? Most customers tell me you determine those specifications which are critical to your organization, and then you look through a table like this one, and the model which is least expensive that covers those critical specs is the one that you buy or one above it. That's what you do when you buy the instrument. Our question to you is, are you going to rely on those same critical specifications the next year, 5 years later, or even beyond that? Because if you are, calibration is really important. Because the calibration determines the real specifications that you're presently operating to when your instrument is measured, just like we did when we originally built it and shipped it to you the first time. Whenever I'm in person, I like to stop and ask the audience this question. When you send your instrument into a calibration lab, what do you expect them to do? This is a fairly comprehensive definition of what calibration is. It is the process where you verify instrument specifications by measuring actual performance using external lab standards, normally instruments, which in turn have better performance and which are traceable to the International System of Units via one of the National Metrology Institutes, who themselves are signatories of the Mutual Recognition Agreement. You know, if you're a metrologist, you probably agree with everything I said, and that's completely correct. But there's a lot of folks out there who would say, wow, that was a bit much. So I want to show you a much simpler operating definition, which isn't quite as complete, but which covers the main elements. And here it is. This is how we define it at Agilent. We measure the actual performance of every warranted specification for every installed option, and we do that every time. Every spec, every option, every time. Real simple to remember. That's how you know that your instrument is still operating like it did when we shipped it to you. Now, this is a good point for me to mention a cautionary note, and that is if you're being offered functional tests, a functional test does not test the actual performance. You want actual performance of all of those measurements. That's how you do calibration. As part of the new product introduction for every new instrument, we develop a series of performance tests, and these are designed to measure the actual performance of all of the warranted specifications. So here you see an example for one of our high performance spectrum analyzers, and you'll see that depending on which model, there's over 40 different performance tests. What I'd like to do now is we're going to run through a little series, and you're going to see on the upper line some measurements that Agilent did, and this is an actual comparison where there was another lab that also measured this RF signal generator. So everywhere you see a green dot, it means that's an actual measurement that was performed. The important thing to note here is, suppose your company is depending on the specification. You bought that instrument from that earlier chart that I showed, and you bought it on the basis of any of the specifications that are inside the yellow oval. In this case, those were not measured, so you don't know. That's why at Agilent, we feel it's important to measure every spec every time. Now, everybody in your company contributes to the overall success of your business. Who in your company is responsible for measurement? If you're listening to this and you're responsible for measurement, part of that responsibility is to find out more about calibration, get involved, and you can trust, but make sure you verify that the specifications that your company counts on are being measured accurately during calibration. Now, what I'd like to show you is, when I said trust but verify, how do you do that? You can do a sample audit. Find an instrument that you like to use on a frequent basis. Identify the key specs that you bought it for. Make sure that you understand which specs is your company depending on. Then look at the measurement report that you receive in calibration, and you should be able to identify which tests were conducted that verify those particular specifications. If you didn't receive a measurement report, frankly, that's a red flag. If you happen to send it to Agilent, we will give you a measurement report for every measured result, either before, if we do adjustments, you will get a before adjustments and after adjustments report. But every measurement that we make, you will get a record of that. If you're sending your instruments to Agilent, we post online all of your measurement results, and they're available at any time, 24/7 for up to 7 years. I have a printed out version of one of those with me right now, and this is for a PXI spectrum analyzer, just as an example. So what you receive is a full trace report and a summary of tests, and in addition to your calibration certificate, you'll get a measurement result of all the tests that we ran, and in addition, if we found it necessary to run adjustments, you'll also receive a second report of all the measurements that we performed after the adjustments were finished. So that brings us to the end of the first module on why calibrate. We have a number of other modules that we've put together that we think would be real interest to you, and I hope that you'll consider watching those as well, and I look forward to seeing you again soon. Thank you.